Cause you know just what to say, and you know just what to do.
Culture Club. Hello, I'm MikeRo here, and welcome to the Culture Club. It's going to be more of a kind of comedy series, I suppose, if you like. But, like, it's just a bit of fun, more than, like, the Liverpool career mode. These are all very serious, you know, standard career modes that people do. But for those that like a bit of pop culture and a bit of lightheartedness, then this is the series for you, as long as you find my sense of humour funny, which I'm not banking on, but I hope that you do. To clarify, then, Culture Club, the idea came to me through... you know, the opening sketch, no word of a lie, I'm a massive Lionel Richie fan, that happened, and then I thought, what if I created a football club of all my favourite pop culture celebrities? And yeah, and then the Culture Club was born. It's as simple as that, really. So, the rules of Culture Club are as follows. Rule number one is we have 24 to 25 celebrities that I have created, okay? They're going to be with us for, I'm hoping, the entire journey. This is essentially an RTG. So we're going to do a road to glory from League 2 all the way up to the Premier League and then to win the Champions League. I'm giving myself a limit, and I'm sure I'll get it done before then, but I'm going to give myself a limit of trying to do it within about maybe 8 or 9 seasons. Okay, that's if it doesn't go well. The goalposts may change depending on how well we're doing. I honestly have no idea how it's going to go, because creative players I haven't tried on FIFA 18. I haven't tried them in years. I used to do it on like FIFA 12 and 11, like when I was a lot younger. Back then, in the FIFA 11 and FIFA 12 days, the creative players used to grow exponentially. They grow so quickly, or they grew so quickly, sorry. To nullify that, rule number two is there will be no training of any of the creative players. I don't want to abuse the training OP system. It's still completely overpowered. To be fair, I messed around with the ages. So we have a good mix. We have no one that's like in their 30s, like over 32, but like I think some of them are around about 28, 27, 26. So they're in their prime years, and then you've got a few of the players are a bit younger. Not every one of them is 16, 17 Wonder Kids. All right, I didn't want to do it like that. And the reason for that is rule number three, the only players that we can buy are going to be youth talents. So pretty much all our money is going to be going into the youth development. It's all going to be going towards scouts, and if I have unlocked it now, because I started a new profile obviously for my YouTube, the Scout Future Star. So the team that I've chosen to be the host of Culture Club is Stevenage FC, and you may be wondering why. Essentially, A, I just really like the kit. I have a thing about the Stevenage kit. And I also did a career mode with them offline, obviously, about 2 years ago. And I have to say, it was difficult. I got really into it, but then after a few seasons, as with time got away with me, I didn't have the time to keep doing it, to be honest. So I think I got to about the championship, and after that I just ran out of time and I just didn't finish it. So I feel like I had unfinished business with them, and obviously doing the series is going to keep me on track to keep doing that. So one of the other reasons why I decided that we should have Stevenage as the team is because they are very, very hefty on youth development, and youth development is going to be a crucial part of this series because we're not allowed to buy any other players other than youth players. I was thinking about free agents, but I think that might tie into another career mode I'm going to do later on, because there'll be more RTGs. That's my favourite type of career mode, so there will be more, and I want to abuse the free agents then. And obviously, at the first season, they never change. So I don't want to be buying the same players in this career mode that I'm going to be buying in latter career modes, if you see what I mean. Like I said, youth development for Stevenage is crucial, right? So they've asked us to sign at least 3 players younger than 20 years old with a potential greater than the average of the players in the starting team. That shouldn't be too hard, because at the moment, the average overall rating of the players in our first team isn't that great. So we should be okay with that, to be honest. Brand exposure, there's no point, it's not even that high, but it's just the 85% consecutive home matches. We can't control that, so it doesn't matter. Continental success. There is no continental success, obviously. Domestic success. We have to fight for promotion this year. Stevenage is still one star. Even with the players I've added, Stevenage is still one star. They're not brilliant on this. I've just literally made them so they are one star. So we are still probably a playoff to maybe high mid-table team. And then we also have to reach round 32 of the FA Cup, which hopefully shouldn't be too hard. And financial is keep player salary for under 25%, which we should be able to do because we're ending us on youth players and you don't pay them any wages, so it shouldn't be a problem. Right, and here is the squad. Up front, we have Anthony Joshua. Big fan, probably the most likeable English sportsman in a while. Definitely at present, he's probably the most likeable one. Oh, well. Well. Ignore the picture on the squad. I'd like to point out that apparently you can't have too many blank-faced players in the squad because some of the players, all the ones I've created, obviously, have got blank faces, as they should do. Some of them seem to have taken original Stevenage players pictures, and some of them are quite funny because that guy there is meant to be Lionel Richie. Lionel is my favourite ever human being. There's no getting around it. I can't explain to you why I like him as much as I do. I love his music. I love him. He's just a legend in my mind. And he was, like I said, he came to me in the dream. He is the fulcrum of this career mode, and I hope that you will learn to love him as much as I do. Yeah, central attacking midfielder, Bruno Tonioli. Probably the best entertainment on a Saturday night television in the BBC. Italian flair. Like a really nice spaghetti bolognese. Left mid, Simon Webb. One love. Absolutely love Blue. Favourite boy band, possibly ever. Hands down. He was my favourite bloke as well. He was great. Tim Hinman has changed, apparently. Quite a lot. That could not... You couldn't be less Tim Hinman if you tried. David Attenborough. This picture could be here maybe like 40 or 50 years earlier. I don't know what he looked like back then. Probably a handsome devil, I'd imagine. David Attenborough's a legend. I'm pretty sure most young people my age as well love him as much as I do. I think he's terrific. And I just hope he never goes. There's a bit of a boy band theme going on here. Then we've got Ben from A1. And that's not because I'm trying to mould my hair on him, as you can tell by the sort of semi-curtains look. But just A1 were great. And Caught in the Middle is one of like my favourite songs ever. If you haven't listened to it, go listen to it. And then at centre-backs, we have Arne Schwarzenegger. Grew up watching his like old 80s sci-fi films. And the amount of puns the bloke stuck in was incredible. I love puns. What can I say? Then Arnie's a beast. I just needed someone that's going to tank and destroy people at the back. Who better than Arnie? The Terminator. Partnering Arnie in defence, we have Nick Knowles, DIY SOS legend. Professor Brian Cox is a legend as well. Billions of stars. Millions of goals. And then you have Noel in goal. Noel Edmonds. At uni, I grew up watching Deal or No Deal. I spent hours doing it. And it was great. Pierce Bronholm. Forget Mamma Mia, forget all that crap. Think Dante's Peak, think Goldeneye, think Taffin. If any of you have not seen the film Taffin, do yourself a favour, go and watch it. But do not take it too seriously. It's early Bronholm, at his best. Paddy McGuinness, no lackey. He will be our reserve goalie. Richard Osman from Pointless, big giant who sits behind the desk, really, really knowledgeable, absolutely love him, couldn't fit the glasses on him in this, but obviously I'm making up for that with these. Declan Donnelly, so I'm sure you can guess who else is probably going to be in the team, because they always come as a pair, not him, it's not Deck and Ainsley Harriet. Yeah, that's meant to be Ainsley Harriet, obviously not in the picture, that's not Ainsley Harriet. Ainsley Harriet, Ray Steady Cook. It's a green pepper. I love it. Absolutely love it. And then at right back, we have Sean Bean. And no, I don't anticipate he's going to die in this series. Okay, I know the joke you're all thinking. But he might survive this one. This guy isn't actually meant to be a celebrity, right? I won't lie, he just turned up. I think you can only have a minimum in a squad. I just missed him. So Kennedy will be going. I'm not going to sell him to get extra money. I'm just going to release him on free. Or if a bid comes in, I'll put it down to 0 million and then we'll sell him that way. I don't want to get the extra money because that feels like cheating. Okay, so ignore him. Kevin McLeod from Grand Designs will be the other right back. He's scathing, full of scorn, treats people like they're idiots. He's brilliant. Love him. There's the man. Ant and Deck. They come as a pair. You couldn't have one and not the other. Then we have Fred Sirier. I think that's how you say it, or Sirier X, if you want to call it that. But he's the guy off of First Dates, the maitre d'. Gary Barlow. Today, Gary, this could be the greatest day of your life because you were in the Culture Club. Greg Wallace, MasterChef, legend. Jeff Stelling, for anyone who loves their football, I love Gillette Soccer Saturday, and it would not be the same without Jeff. I could have put Chris Kamara in there, but I thought it would be a bit unfair because he was an ex-footballer, so I'd actually have to make him quite good. As you can see, they're all around about low 60s, only a few or a little bit higher. I tried to get some better players and then some alright players, and then you've got some 50s in there, so some less decent players. Okay, there's no reflection on what their skills might be like in real life. That's just how I've had to do it for this series. You'll notice that even though Lionel Richie is my favourite player, he is actually only rated 62, so I've been fair. So due to the length of the series, I want these episodes to be short, sharp and snappy. Okay, so I'm not going to play any of the preseason friendlies. I'm going to sim through this month because we can't make any transfers. There's no point in actually going through the transfer window. Alright, hopefully we'll do well in the tournament. We do well in the tournament, we get extra money. We put that towards the youth scouting. So I'm going to try and get it so we get a scout report on the first of every month. Then we can check it out, bring players into the academy, see how they're getting on. Hopefully, it'll put us in good stead. To run you through some of the other things that we're going to do in the series while I wait. I'm a big stats man, and because this is a series is going to have a lot more longevity than, like, for example, the Liverpool career mode that we're doing, I'm going to be keeping like stats and tallies all the way through the season. So at the end of it, whenever we get to the end of the series, we're going to look back and see who got the most goals, who got the most assists, maybe who got the best rating overall. I'd like you guys to sort of comment on who you think will be our best player, who you think is probably going to get the most goals, and all these things. Well, we have some good news and we have some bad news. Good news is that we actually earned around about over 500k or 600k in the preseason friendly tournament, which is excellent. We're going to use that for the youth scouts. The bad news is that Ainsley Harriott probably won't be smiling for a while because he's managed to break his elbow, which is a bit concerning in itself. We've not been given the best deal here in terms of scout reports, unfortunately. I've had a look through and there's no one. Obviously, you've got Mikael Madsen, but even that's a 5 and a 3. There's not 5 and a 5, and we're not going to be able to afford a 5 and a 5, so I'm going to go quantity over quality to start with. So we're going to get a 2-star, 3-star English scout, and we'll send him to England, and we'll get some. Let's get some physically strong players, because I didn't make our players too physically brilliant in this. I didn't want to abuse the pace. Right, we're going to wait for another week or so to get another scout out there. But at least we've got one out and about in England, and that's what matters. We've got someone out there, and let's just see how we get on with that. One thing I will do, though, while we're here, is I'm going to get the scout future star. Start as you mean to go on. It's the first unlockable I've actually taken off of my MikeRo account, so I'm going to put that through, and let's see what we get. Well, first, we have a transfer offer for Ben Kennedy, which is good news. What I'm going to do is I'm going to negotiate that. I'll try and sell him off for free. Okay, I made that promise at the start. I'm going to try and sell him for free because I don't want us to have the additional money because it will feel like cheating because he shouldn't even be in the squad. Okay, I can sell him for £1. All right, so let's sell him for £1. That's not going to make any difference, okay? I understand you're not willing to part with Kennedy that easily, so we will give you that pound. Thanks, mate. But yeah, hopefully then Kennedy will go. Some may say we've undersold him. He may be rubbish. He may only be worth £1, I don't know. The big news, though, is that our scout future star has arrived, a chap called Hervé Alphand, and I have no idea how good he is, so we're about to find out together. Watch my reaction if it's good. I'm thinking Swedish striker. I'm going to go hard. I never ever get strikers on this, but I'm going to say Swedish striker. Okay. Well, we don't have many CDMs, so I suppose that's not too bad. Yeah, he's French, so I was miles off. Overall 55, 67 to 87, really? He looks physically strong though, which can't be a bad thing. He's 5'10", so he's not tiny. Let's sign him up anyway. We'll promote him to the first team. We need the numbers, so let's promote him. Our first youth player is here. So there he is. Hervé Alphand. He's got some alright physicals, to be fair. He's not too bad. 3-star, 3-star, and medium work rate. So actually, that's pretty good. He'll be a good squad player, I think, overall. His free kick stats aren't actually that bad, so maybe he is actually going to be a good free kick taker for us. Let's see how he starts. Yeah, that's alright. His stamina's already gone up, so he's already improving, which is always great news. Big news, Ben Kennedy is gone, and we have received £0 allocated to the budget, so it's worked out perfectly. All that's happened is that we've got his wage, and we can't do anything with that because we're only signing youth players, so it's worked out perfectly. So here we are at Broadhall Way, or the Lamex Stadium, I am told that's what it's called. I think that's probably down to, I don't know, I'm assuming sponsorship. Newport, I have played a few lower league RTGs in my time offline, and Newport's always the team I struggle against. I haven't played them that much this year, so I don't know how good they are, but I'm not looking forward to this already. It's always really difficult because I'm used to playing with like higher quality players. We line up with our actual starting lineup, and oh, I need to change some of the numbers. I've just seen them. That's absolutely horrendous. Arnie cannot be number one. Noel Edmonds, Arnie, Nick Knowles, and Brian Cox make up the goalie in the back three. Webb, Henman, Attenborough, Ben from A1, and Bruno Tonioli make up our midfield five. And Anthony Joshua partners Lionel Richie up front. Lionel's got the correct number. That's all that matters. It's not. I need to change all the numbers. I'm absolutely livid. I've forgotten to do that. So next episode, bear that in mind. Tell me what shirt numbers you want everyone to have. There you go. I've made it that way. Newport County lineup with a 5-3-2. They've got Day, Dimitri, O'Brien, Bennett, White, and Barnum Bob. What a name! In the back five with Ben Toza, Labadi, and Rigg as the midfield three. Newport and Quigley up front. I recognise a few of them. I'm loving the name Barnum Bob. I'm annoyed I can't sign him because what a great name that is, Barnum Bob. The other guys there getting into a huddle. It's a big season. The RTG starts now. Culture Club starts now. I'm so excited! And they're going to get a chance here if they play their cards right. That's well played from Ben from A1. And then we've got that up here. Lionel's come back. We need him closer to the goal, really. Tiger Tim's on the ball. Tiger Tim's going on a run. Tiger Tim! Tiger Tim! Oh, Tiger Tim, you idiot! Tim Henman, no! It was a wonderful run. But he just, I don't know why I did the low driven shot. I didn't just pelt it into the top corner. And now Newport on the counter. Oof! Good effort from Quigley. Nice open game. Good. Ben from A1 to Dave Attenborough. We've not quite hit the heights like I was hoping we would. Anthony Joshua, though, he's turned his man. Ah! God. Irritating. Can we get on the counter before half time? No, we can't. What a rubbish half. This is nice from Cy Webb. Has he got the pace to get away from his man? Only just. He's going to knock that. That's lovely from Lionel to Anthony Joshua. Oh, what a save! That was a good save. That's a great save. Tim's going to swing this ball in, and Attenborough nearly got his head on it. Brian Cox has picked up the ball, composed on the ball. You idiot, Brian. You're too laid back, mate. Two in the cosmos, not enough on the pitch. Oh my God. They're just so fucking defensive, don't you dare. Oh, great save from Noel. Under pressure. They're so defensive. The 5-3-2 is so annoying. Win that header. Gave myself 8 or 9 seasons, was it? Jesus Christ. Just not been at it. No, can't do anything about that. It's a great header from Newball. And the boys are in trouble already. It's not good. A few players have really not impressed me here at all, and I'm worried that we've got some damp squibs in the team. Tonioli is one. He's meant to be one of our better players, and he's done absolutely nothing. Lionel! Get in! Lionel Richie! Oh, what a feeling! When we're dancing on the ceiling! There will be, I'm sure, a parody of that somewhere along the line. But the big man has got us the ball. He's got us that goal. Was it Bruno? Snagging him off, and then he plays a lovely little ball through to Lionel to finish. Never in doubt once he got in the box. Fox in the box. Fox in the bedroom. Absolute legend. I don't know he's a fox in the bedroom. I can only assume from the amount of wonderful songs he's made. Probably makes love to them. I actually read an article saying that he doesn't. I'm not obsessed. I'm not. 1-1. Come on! I was going to knock it. Oh, that's lovely from Attenborough. The pressure's piling on now. Tiger Tim to Dave Attenborough. He's going to have a crack. Oh! That will be Dave's last involvement. Him, Joshua and Webber coming off for Pierce Brosnan, Deck and Richard Osman. I'm hoping that Pierce is going to be able to bring in some of his magic. I'm thinking action Pierce right now. I'm thinking Dante's Peak Pierce. Paul, get out of there now, please. The world is not enough. Well done, Bruno. Tee that. To Ben from A1. Oh, mate. Oh, come on. Brian Cox wouldn't hurt a fly. Look at him. He's so gentle. Oh, what? Yellow for that. Nonsense. Billions of stars. I'm sorry, it's going to get old quite quickly, I know, and I will try and keep it to a minimum. Oh, for God's sake. Oh. No. 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 No! Ben! I knew it the minute I'd made the tackle. I knew it the minute I'd made the tackle. Didn't need to do it. Come on, Noel. Oh, he went the right way! Oh. Told you I don't play well against Newport County. Oh, Pierce couldn't get away with the run. Pierce? No! Oh, Pierce Brosnan! Get in, Bronholm! Yes! Yes! Oh. Yes, Pierce. Action Pierce does it the best. Don't worry, he's got a snorkel. That's a Dante's Peak reference if you didn't get it. Worst finish ever. He's literally spanked it at the goalie. And he needs to test his wrists out. Because they're pretty flimsy. Pierce Brosnan. Get in. So happy. Go on, Deck. Look how tiny he is. Go on. What a ball. Lionel. Lionel. Lionel! Oh! He snicked it! Oh. Lionel Richie! He's nicked it! Who played the ball? What a pass! And from the depths of despair, we have turned it around. Come on! What a ball! What a finish! What a man! What a human being! Ah, oh, exceptional. Composure personified. All night long. All night long, he'll do that. All night. All night long. All night. I need to figure out who played that pass. I need to know. I'll find out on the assists at the end of the game. But what a ball it was. I'm just saying it, but if it was Deck that played the ball, I'm calling managerial genius, and we're away again. Declan Donnelly has changed the game. Declan Donnelly. Declan
to Brunholm. Oh! Close.
What a game!
What a second half. The first half was absolute dog food. And this has been magical. Oh, Brunholm nearly got there to Professor Brian. He's going to go to the line. No, he's not. He's going to tee it back to Deck. Deck's going to whip in a ball. Oh, what a save! Henman. Oh, dear me. That was terrible from Tim. But we somehow escaped with a win. What a game. If the rest of the series is going to be like this, then bring it on. Absolute magic. That man. Praise the Lionel. Insane. Well done, Lionel. Great, great performance. 3 shots, 2 goals. Can't ask for much more than that. That ball for his second goal and the winner. I just need to see it again. I need to find it again. It was just superb. I need to find it again. Match ratings wise, no surprises, you did get man of the match, Lionel. If you get a winner and you score a brace, you're pretty much going to get there, my friend. Well done, boys. Lionel with 9.4, then he does get man of the match. Bruno Tonelli, 8.9, so he played quite well. Brian Cox also got 7.7. Everyone played actually all right, to be fair, and I won't disagree with that. We got a bit unlucky with a couple of the goals. One of them was a stupid tackle from May for the penalty. Tim Henman. Of course it was. He was my second man of the match, although I thought Henman, especially in the first half, where it was quite boring, he dominated it. And he played the ball for the goal. So what more can you say, Tim? You are an absolute gem of a man. And I say that it was quite even. You look at the stats, it really wasn't. We absolutely dominated them. So I'm going to say that we deserved that win. And we've ground it out. Come on, you boys. My breath's taken out after that game. That was just an unbelievable game of football. What a start. What a start to the series. Could not have gone better. I'm looking forward to the next episode then. We have the Carabao Cup tie against Southend away, which will be very difficult because obviously they're in the division above us, I think. I think what we'll probably end up doing is rotating the squad, and we might put a second team out for that and see some of the other players. We're going to get to see them all over the course of the game because we don't have a big squad, so we're going to need that. So that'll be in the next episode, the away game against Southend in the League Cup. Then we're away at Colchester and then home to Grimsby. If I have time, I might fit the Barnet one in there. Like I said, I want the episodes to be shorter and I want to get through the career a bit quicker. But I want to show you all the highlights from all the games. So I don't know if I'll do that post-com. I don't want to. I want to do face cam for all of it because A, I've got to get used to it. And B, I'm hoping that you're enjoying it a bit more, seeing my reactions and all the weird faces I pull when I score goals. Thank you so much for watching the episode. If you have enjoyed it, please do like and subscribe and share. I'm hoping that you're enjoying the idea of Culture Club. I know I am. It's just a fun series, a bit of a laugh, and I hope that you can get on board with it. Please let me know about the player numbers. If you have any suggestions on who should have what, then please let me know. That'd be great. And until I see you again, stay cool. Cheers.